Thank you, Danielle and Nicole, and thank you, Judy, for having them. Wes Vining. This is a different thing this morning. I've been looking forward to it for weeks. And I'm giving it to Wes. He's going to take it from there, and he'll have help in a minute.
Thank you, I guess. First of all, I want to take an opportunity to just thank all of you who have prayed for me during my back surgery. I think I'm doing well. Anyway, I'm upright and I'm feeling good, but I appreciate that. And for all of you who are here to hear Kurt, I apologize. You can either go to sleep or you can kind of listen in and see what we're going to do. But this morning, what I want to talk to you about is something that I think is very, very important, because frequently we talk about scriptures and we talk about living the Christian life and we talk about doing things, but we don't actually sometimes see things being done. We're good talkers, but we're not necessarily good doers sometimes. But I think this church is exceptional. And the reason I think this church is exceptional is largely in part, and he can't say this, but I can, is because Pastor Kurt is exceptional. Pastor Kurt shows us his love, he shows us his care, and he shows the community that. In fact, somebody in the community, a police officer in the community, recently remarked, that church in the old grocery store is sure making a difference. And that's pretty important. And you know what? I want to tell you that you are part, you're following our leader, and you are doing a good job at representing Christ. And you are making a difference in some people's lives. And today I am going to tell a story. That's another stupid thing for me to have, be telling a story when Kurt's here, because he's the ultimate storyteller, right? But anyway, I'm going to try and tell a story. And I want to tell a story, and I want you to understand that you are a very integral part in this story. Because every one of you contribute to the atmosphere of this congregation. Whether you want to or not. If you don't want to, stay home. But if you are here, you contribute to the atmosphere. And that atmosphere is generally an atmosphere of, we care about the public, we care about the community, we care about each other, and we want to do something about it. And that's where I want to go today. You know, we could look up a lot of scriptures, and I encourage you to do this in your time, but in 1 Peter chapter 4, for instance, it tells us to be hospitable. We need to love and to serve each other because we care. And that's what we're talking about. In Galatians 5, it says, love your neighbor as yourself. You've all heard that. That's pretty hard to do if you've got a neighbor like mine. Okay? But we're supposed to try to do that. We're supposed to try to show love. 1 Timothy, it says, do good, be rich in good works, ready to give, willing to share, because that will help us store up a good foundation to come, for things to come. We can go on and on. 2 Corinthians 8, it says, be generous. Generosity is a natural result of sincere love. That's a paraphrase. Be generous. Generosity is a natural result of sincere love. Well, today, I want to tell a story. I want to tell a story about how consistent Christian living, living a Christian life in front of people, makes a difference. My story isn't supposed to focus on an individual, because, but it's going to. It's going to be on an individual, but this individual is no different than the rest of us. We have had situations and we know people who are going to be able to relate to the story I tell you today. Some of you may be able to relate pretty closely. Because you know, in life, we have up and downs, don't we? Sometimes we find ourselves in a spiral, kind of. Sometimes that spiral isn't going up. Sometimes that spiral is going down. But the bright side of the story is this person who was in a spiral and it was going in the wrong direction met up with you people, met up with Pastor Kirk, and there's a bright side of the story. And the bright side of the story is because of meeting up with people like you, people like Pastor Kirk, this person has a new opportunity to evaluate life, has a new opportunity to reevaluate where he stands before the Lord. Because we are trying to live that kind of a Christian life. And I want to encourage you through this talk, I want to encourage you to keep doing it. Keep working. Keep showing Christian love. Before I tell the story, let's pause for a word of prayer. Father, we just ask that we won't get in the way. We just ask that this story will click with some of us. And it will show some of us that we really want to show love more than we ever have before. For others of us, perhaps we're going to identify with the person, and the person is that's in the spiral and not going in the right direction. Perhaps for those, they will see that it's an opportunity to turn that around if they're willing to do so. Lord, we just don't know where each one of us are, but we do know that we're here because we love you, and we're here because we want to serve you in whatever way we can. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Let me start with a story. My story begins in 1945. Most of you know a little bit about 1945. Some of you were there, I can tell. 1945 was the end of the war. April 30th, Hitler supposedly put a gun to his head and blew his brains out. On May 7th of that year, Germany surrendered. It was over. 1945, September, Japan surrendered. They'd had enough. And the war is over. Now guess what? There's a huge sigh of relief in the world. That sigh of relief is the war to end all wars is done. And our soldiers are going home. And they go home from both sides. They go home from the German side, from the Japanese side, from the US side, from the British side. They all cross the big pond again. And in 1945, they knew what all young American men. The baby boom starts. And that's where a lot of you guys came from. My friend, the same thing. In 1946, my friend is born. He's a result of that, but he's born in Bavaria, Germany. The fellow I want to tell a story about. You see, 1946 was a great year. You remember that? Remember lots of things about it? Hirohito, remember who he was? Hirohito decides he's not God after all. When the U.S. people got there, they said, you're not God, don't tell everybody you're God, you better change your story. January 1st, he declares he's not God. Hirohito, that's important. January 10th, U.S. makes first contact with the moon with radar.
Wow!
Was that horrible? Operation Deadlights in February.